this property has the potential of becoming Masjid. It's a historic property. This is the property where Dr. Martin Luther King spoke. Dr. Martin Luther King marched from. This was a civil rights icon in 1968. This building, it was once the Second Presbyterian Church. I could see from the top that it could actually be a minaret up there, and the adhan can be given five times a day. It's located in downtown Memphis, next to the FedEx Forum. It's a beautiful area, historic area, well known. It has plenty of parking all around. It's a redeveloped area, a redeveloping area. It can be what could make the Muslim community or communities around the country very proud to acquire an historic building in downtown Memphis, a historic religious institution structure. It's beautiful. It's stone. It's constructed in a way that has some characteristics of the old English style properties, but other than that, it's just a beautiful place. I think that the Muslim community in Memphis, Tennessee, should do everything that it possibly could to impact this city as Muslims, as people of faith and belief, to impact it in a way that would register in the hearts and the minds of the city of Memphis and Memphians everywhere and people in the country in general. To associate an Islamic masjid to this property is similar to shaking hands with Dr. Martin Luther King and all of the civil rights icons and leaders who visited this building during the Memphis sanitation strike, Memphis sanitation protests and boycotts and strikes. It's a symbol of freedom, a freedom of expression, economic freedom. It's a symbol of civil rights right here in Memphis, Tennessee. So my thinking is that we should come together, raise whatever monies that's necessary to be raised, and purchase this property, completely renovate the property, and make it the house of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the home of the Muslims around the world. Assalamu alaikum.